since 2020 ang India pinagbawal ang TikTok sa mga government officials and government employees.
Yes, we do, no? Namo-monitor naman namin yung galaw ng ibang mga bansa. Siguro what I can do is I can raise this, no? With the National Security Advisor kung it would be proper for us to do so, no? Kasi alam mo naman dito sa Pilipinas, sasabihin na naman yan, a curtailment of the freedom of expression, curtailment of the freedom of speech, no? So we will need to study this very carefully if it is merited based on national security considerations.
Pero di po ba pag nagtrabaho ka naman talaga sa gobyerno, nababawasan ng freedom?
Tama po yan. Tama po yan. No? But no, that is why siguro ang gagawin po namin in the future is I'll probably discuss this with the National Security Advisor if it will be proper for the Philippines to take this step. Naghanda kami para sa West Philippine Sea, yung balita, TikTok. Ito talagang si, ano. No, I was just being, not really, kasi, siguro I'll phrase my answer in the need for us to be more security conscious, no? Kasi we know for a fact that there are information operations and psychological warfare and other stuff being done. So siguro if there is a need for banning, no, it would not be for public school teachers, it would not be for those in the civilian, it would be for the security sector. Okay, I'm talking about the armed forces, the uniformed personnel, and in particular, the intelligence entities of government, the National Security Council. I would think that we should seriously consider, you know, for the security sector alone, not for the other civilian agencies of government, which are not part of the security sector. And precisely, the reason is for operational security.